Now to a Local 10 News investigation into the Stoneman Douglas massacre and word that Parkland's commanding officer is being removed from her post. Here's investigator Bob Norman with the fallout.
The city of Parkland has requested that a new police chief come in for that district.
With that city request, embattled Broward Sheriff's Captain Jan Jordan was removed from her post today, nearly 4 months after the shooting at Marjory Stoneman Douglas High. It was a move that needed to be made, said Broward Commissioner Michael Udine.
I think that this is probably the first of many changes that we're going to see as far as public safety in this area. When you have what you had on February 14th, there's got to be accountability.
Hi, Captain.
Jordan has refused to answer questions about the shooting.
I don't have any comments. Sorry.
Well, it's really important. Have you ever done incident command before?
A record show that while deputies stood outside as students and staffers were being shot, her first radio transmission was about setting up a perimeter rather than going in.
I know there's a lot going on. Do we have the perimeter set up right now?
Last week, it was learned that when a Coral Springs deputy fire chief requested to allow medics into the building to treat the wounded, Jordan refused six times over several minutes, repeating that she, quote, had to check.
An incident commander needs to be able to make real-time snap decisions. And if they can't make real-time snap decisions, then they're not the incident commander, and somebody else needs to replace that incident commander.
Despite that, Broward Sheriff Scott Israel kept her in place until the city request to remove her came Wednesday.
If paramedics would have gotten in there quicker, I think lives would have been saved.
Now, the city also announced today that it's hired an outside firm to review the entire BSO contract. Will it switch police services to nearby Coral Springs? Only time will tell on that one. In Parkland, I'm Bob Norman, Local 10 News.